Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Liaquat Zaman, and as you can tell, this is another vlog. So I thought I'd keep you guys up to date with what's happening. So if you haven't been following, I have started Al Manfluti series, which is basically a very advanced text in Arabic. And it's for those people who have studied a bit of Arabic, but now want to kind of like really, really brush up on their Arabic writing skills. And I encourage those of you guys who know Arabic and you want to brush up on your Arabic, check out those videos and just write in the comments. That's the main thing, that is, because one of the things that I learned when I was studying in madrasa, because a lot of you guys have been asking me, how did you learn Arabic? And the reality is that when I learned Arabic from scratch. So I've kind of gone from bottom up, and I've gone, you know, through all the different sort of like experiences of learning Arabic, studying it with teachers who only taught in Arabic. And I spoke with friends who only spoke Arabic, or the common language between us was Arabic. I used to try and write Arabic. I used to try and read any sort of literature in Arabic I could get my hands on. I would try to read it as best as possible. So you can imagine how much effort has to go into trying to learn a new language, especially if you haven't really had any practice or any tips on how to learn the language, apart from kayfa hal, na'am, assalamu alaikum, akhi, ukhti, right? These are the kind of normal sort of little words that people throw around to each other in Arabic. But so going back to what I was saying, so check out the Manfluti series. And when I was in madrasa, I was actually practicing a lot of Arabic. We actually had started this little club kind of thing in the madrasa, where on a weekly basis or fortnightly basis, we used to have this competition of writing Arabic. Now, the thing is, in writing and speaking, is you can't be shy, right? You, as best as possible, do not be shy. Because if you're shy, then what happens is you can't learn the language properly. You're going to, you know, be held back. That's the first thing. Second thing is, you need to try and get yourself immersed in Arabic. Now, if you're living in the West, in the UK or any other place which is not the Middle East, and when I was in Pakistan, the same thing, you need to create yourself an environment for Arabic as well, right? That's the second thing that you need to do. Create yourself an environment, meet with people, speak Arabic with them, try your best. I mean, some guys used to go to real extremes. They used to like just stop speaking any language apart from Arabic with everyone. Right, even if the guy didn't know Arabic, you know, he would just try and explain things. And that's something which really helps. And I do this with my students as well. So the ones that I teach, you know, face-to-face and teach them Arabic, I get them to do this as well. I make them speak every single day. I get them to write things in Arabic for me, a few lines. I get them to translate. I get them to listen to the audio and try and, you know, come up with their own sentences. All of these things are going to help in different skills in learning a language. So Manfluti, guys, if you guys want to check it out, I'll leave a link as well, inshallah, you can check that out. Number two, I've also started Kanz. Kanz al-Daqaiq is basically a kind of text in Hanafi fiqh. It's a quite condensed text. It's for those kind of people who have done Quduri. So if you've done my Quduri series, it's a bit more advanced in that sense, and it's focused more on the buyut side. I'm tackling the buyut side, first of all, trade and commerce. So that's for them. And then thirdly, I'm also doing a question and answer. So this question and answers are usually on Saturdays. Saturdays about UK 9 PM for the moment, at the moment. So you can check that out as well. The recordings are there. You can listen to them. They're quite long. You can ask questions, you know, any kind of questions you want. I try to only answer relevant questions. Ones that are not really relevant, I won't probably be answering them. So no point asking them. But I'll try to answer fiqh-related questions as best as possible. If I don't know the answer, I'll try to go back, look up the answer, and try to help you in the best way possible. So that's basically the kind of things that I've been doing when it comes to reading and writing. And also, if you guys want to learn Arabic, I also have, as you guys know, the 17 lessons Quranic Arabic. You can actually do it in your own time. It's pre-recorded lessons. You go through them, you answer the questions, you send them to me or the TAs, you get them marked. And then it really, really helps you in learning the ground rules of Arabic, right? Very, very beneficial. And then after that, you can move on to studying more, serious texts, right? So this is like a very good access course, you can say, that gets you into the Arabic, gets you into appreciating Quran. And think about it, Ramadan is just around the corner. So imagine Ramadan comes this Ramadan, and you're standing in Taraweeh and you're understanding the Imam or a bit of what the Imam's saying, and reading the Quran and interacting with it. it makes, you know, it just so enjoyable. It's unimaginable. Yeah, it's something which you ask anyone who understands the Quran. Ramadan is just a special time for them with their attachment to the Quran. And may Allah make us all of those people who understand the Quran. So, like I said, it's not difficult to learn the language, right? So, try your best, work hard at it, and inshallah, it can be done, right? So, anyway, jazakumullah khair, guys. And I think I'll leave you there as well. Hope you guys have a wonderful time. See, I've been testing with these videos, and as you can see, quality of the videos have changed quite a lot as well. So I've been testing with the camera. Like I did promise you guys, I'm going to be testing with the camera. And alhamdulillah, the quality has improved. And some of the videos, as you can tell, I get them done, edited by another editor. So they do a much better job than me. But alhamdulillah, I'm learning as well. Anyway, so jazakumullah khair, guys. Post in the comments, what's your favorite videos on my channel? Right, what's your favorite videos? What videos do you usually watch the most? Put them in the comments, and I just want to see, get an idea from you guys of what you guys enjoy. So, jazakumullah khair, guys. Thumbs up, or likes, or bell, and subscribe. Share it with your friends, your family. Show them how accessible it is to learn about the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And yeah, jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakumullah khair, guys, for all of your support. Without your support, I wouldn't have been able to produce the videos that I've put up on my YouTube channel. And there is so much more that I really want to do. And without the support of you guys who are patrons, generously supporting this channel, I've been able to get myself a camera, which, as you guys can see, the quality of this camera, a mic system, software, I've been able to hire an editor. So, what do I want to do? I want to make lots and lots and lots of more videos for beginners, for intermediate, advanced, in the subjects like Arabic and fiqh and hadith and tafsir and aqidah and all those other things as well. And for this to happen, again, this channel needs support. So if you guys want to become patrons and support this channel, then check out the link below. Also, if you do become patrons, you'll have access to videos that I don't put up on my normal YouTube channel. So check that out, inshallah. And there's most other perks as well that you guys can benefit from. And if you want to access this channel through social media, we've got Twitter, we've got Instagram, Facebook page, and other things as well that you can visit. So jazakumullah khair again, guys. Thank you very much for your support. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakumullah khair for watching this video. I hope to see all of you guys. If you guys are interested, please leave us feedback, get in contact with us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.